Hello everyone, my name is Stefan Philips. I'm a PhD student at the TU Delft and I work in the Van der Sijpe group, and in the Van der Sijpe group we work on electron spin qubits, and one of the systems that we study are electron spin qubits in silicon. So the way to think about it could be the following. So suppose you would have a silicon substrate. What you want to do is actually to catch one electron, single electron in the substrate, and that would form your spin qubit. So the thing you could do is you could take your silicon wafer and on top of it put some metal gates, and these metal gates you can bias positively or negatively, or in other words they can either way attract electrons or repel electrons. And what you and the next step is then to choose voltages in such a way you can exactly get one electron under this gate, and then once you have this electron, the next thing you can do is to put it in a magnetic field. When an electron is put in a magnetic field, you will actually see that you get two spin states. One spin state that is spin up, and the other spin state that is spin down. And in our lab, we have already shown that you can put multiple electrons in a row, and then we form small quantum algorithms. And what we see there is that these algorithms are actually not perfect. In a sense, they don't give always the right answer. And the reason for that is that sometimes some errors happen when you do your quantum gates. So that are the quantum operations between your electrons. And other errors that also can happen is that you have that your electron interacts with your environment. So for example, when you're in spin-up, your electron could interact with some nuclei in silicon lattice and then relax to spin down. That's one example. There are many. And where I would like to focus on in my PhD is actually to kind of prevent those errors from happening. Or in said in a better way, you kind of let the errors happen and then you measure them, and the fact that you can measure them, then you can correct them. So the way to do that could be the following. So what we did until now was to use one single electron as one qubit that is used in your quantum computation, and then that one qubit forms your memory. But another option would be to actually use multiple qubits that actually form one logical qubit, and in that way you could the idea is to make of multiple already good qubits a very good qubit. And the way to do that is that you actually make a complex state which is kind of symmetric. And one thing you can do if you have a state is measure its symmetry, and when you measure the symmetry, the quantum information is maintained, but you can kind of keep check of the symmetry. And here the tricky thing is that you need to choose the right symmetry, and whenever you would have some relaxation event like this, what you would see is that your symmetry changes. And since you're continuously measuring the symmetries, you can actually actively correct for this. And this is quantum error correction. And to show this in a small system of qubits, that's mainly where I'm focusing on.